In this video, I'll show you how you can scrape company filings data from the SEC for free using Python. Machine learning methods, and especially text analysis, are now more popular than ever in finance research. But to do any text analysis, you need text data. One great source of data, and especially text data, is the Edgar database from the Securities and Exchange Commission. Edgar contains all the public company filings and can be accessed for free by anyone. For example, if I was to look for, say, Apple, well, then I can access all of their latest filings in that website. So that's nice, but that's not how I want to access data. I want to access it programmatically so I can scrape it, save it, and then analyze it later, all in Python. What's even better than just being free? Well, the SEC also makes Edgar easily accessible through programmatic APIs. So that means that you can use those APIs to access the data stored in Edgar. So that's all good, and it's been available for a while, but I'm sure anyone who has tried to use those APIs in the past has seen that, yes, they are available, you can get the data out, but then parsing and processing that data still is a big challenge. So there are multiple modules in Python that make accessing, scraping, and processing the data from SEC Edgar easier, but for me, the Edgar tool library was a game changer. As you'll see in today's video, it makes scraping and processing and extracting the data so much easier. So I really want to thank Dwight Gunning for writing this amazing library. Okay, so let's jump right in. In order to use Edgartools, you need to install the library. So either through pip with pip install Edgartools, or if you're using poetry add Edgartools. And Edgartools under the hood uses multiple libraries, including PyArrow and Pandas, to store and manage the data. So you don't need to especially install them, but you'll be able to easily get some of the data out as Pandas dataframes. So I'll import from Edgar what I need, which is company and set identity. So this will be our entry. In order to first use Edgar, you have to set your identity, which is name and email. That's a rule from the SEC API. Okay, so now I'm all good. I can actually query the API. So say, for example, I wanted to go back and query some data from Apple. So I could just define my company. And then I would pass either the ticker, the CIK code. In this case, I'll give it the ticker. And now we can see it has retrieved some information about Apple. Say, for example, I wanted to get the latest financials. All I'd have to do is go Apple, financials, and then here I'd have the latest financials. If I want to see how the company was named in the past, I can go to Apple, former names, and then here I'd see the different names that they had in the past with the different dates. I can get also their filings. So suppose I wanted to get the 10Qs, so the quarterly earnings data. All I have to do is do get filings. And here I would pass form and say which type of form I want. Well, here I want a 10Q. And then if we look at this, we see that we have a bunch of filings. So there's 90 filings available. If I wanted to get those as a pandas data frame, all I'd do is filings.toPandas, and then it would return me all that filings data as a data frame. So that's all good, but that's only the metadata. Suppose I wanted to get the raw data, then I can get it using a specific method. So first we'll focus on one filing. So suppose I wanted to get the latest 10Q, then I would do latest 10Q. So that's my variable. And for that, I'll get from the filings that we just retrieved, I'll get the latest. And now we can get that specific filing. This is the filing we're after. If we wanted to download it, all we have to do is do latest 10Q, our data that we just got, and then do obj to download the object. And then we'll see what we have. We actually have now the filing, but we do have the content that can be seen here in text, but that's only a summary. So in those 10Qs, you have different types of data. You do have text data from the different sections called items, and you also have financial numeric data. In order to access the items, well, first you can look at the items that are available, so just .items, so that would give you the list of items available in that filing. And now if I want to access, say, item 2, I would just do 10Q, square brackets, item 2. And here I have the text. It is a long string, so I could, if I wanted to see it, I could just print it to render it. And then here I could read this 10Q item. Now, data on Edgar is also stored in XBRL format. So this is a standardized XML-based format for financial reports. If you want to access the parsed data from this format, you can also do that with Edgartools. So in this case, it's not in the filing that we just downloaded. We need to download it separately. So again, that would be from the latest 10Q. We would access the XBRL. And if we look at that, well, it is a new object that has all of that data. So as you can see, it is a table. So we can also access that data as a pandas data frame. All we have to do is go to xbrl.facts.data. And here we have all the data, the underlying data as a pandas data frame. If you found this video useful so far, please like so that others also get to discover it. So 10Qs are only one of the many types of forms that you can get from Edgartools. So these are quarterly reports. You also have the 10Ks, the annual report. And here, let's look at the 8Ks. So those are kind of special disclosures that the firm has to do. So usually it's for material news, press releases, things like that. So say again, let's stick with Apple and go get their latest 8Ks. So here we see we've got recent filings that are available. Not all of them will have press releases. It really depends on what this disclosure is. But say I wanted to get those that have press releases, well, I'll have to download them and check out whether they do have press releases attached or not. So in order to do that, I'll use the fact that once you've downloaded with the obj method, the 8K object as a as press released method. So let's just download the latest 8Ks. So we'll just get the 10 latest and we'll download these. Here they are. Now what I want to do is I want to filter on whether they do have a press release or not, and just keep those that have press releases. Okay, so how many did we get? So 7 of them have press releases. So let's just get the first one. So our press release is going to be 8K, we'll get the first one, and then we'll get the press release. And as we see here, we do have a press release. So press releases, again, it is not the actual press release directly. It is an object of type press releases. This one could have attachments. Attachments are attachments that can be downloaded. So that means that when I downloaded the 8K, the actual content of the 8K, I did not download automatically the attachments. Those would have to be downloaded separately. Here we see there's only one. So if I get the first one, this is it. I can open that one using the open method, and that will open it in my browser. So that's nice if I'm kind of debugging and testing stuff. But now if I wanted to get the data, called this text, I would have to do pr.attachments get 0. And then instead of open, I would do download. Now we can see we have the content of our press release. It is a string. So if we see from the content of the string that we received, it is actually an XML file that has an embedded HTML file into it. So you'll still need to do some work in order to extract the content, probably using Beautiful Soup. Finally, if you just want to quickly get some financial data on a company, say the latest financial data, well, there is the facts or get facts method that lets you get that. So get Apple get facts, that would give me the latest facts, all the latest financials. So that's what we've extracted with the XBRL from a specific filing, but this will let you get the latest information from Apple. And again, if I wanted that as a pandas data frame, I would just have to do two pandas instead, and that would create the pandas data frame. So that's to get the data from one company. But say I wanted to scrape all of Edgar, how would I go about doing that? Well, for that, there's the get filings method. We'll need to import that. And now using this get filings method, I can get all the filings that I want. You can filter using parameters. The one that I really recommend filtering on is all not only the year and quarter, but also the form to get only the filings that you want. So in this case, this would get me all the filings that have been filed so far this year that are of type 10K, so annual reports. So now I have all the 10Ks. I can just use a for loop to iterate over all of these 10Ks and get the data as we've just seen. However, one thing to keep in mind is that the SEC API has a rate limit. So downloading all the 10Ks historically will be quite time consuming. So Edgartools doesn't provide parsing for all the types of form that are available on Edgar, but the most important ones, at least in finance research, are there. So you've got the 10Ks, 10Qs, 8Ks, and a few more. So for example, we could look at 13F, which is the holdings report from institutional investors. So if I wanted to get those 13F, I would just do the same thing with get filings, but use a different form. Now, if I wanted to look at the holdings in that first 13F filing, I would just get the first filing from these filings. Now to download the report, I would just do obg as before. Now we see the report. So the holdings data in those report is stored in an info table. So we'll first have to check whether that specific report has an info table. Yes, so that means that now I can access that table. That table is available as different format, but the actual just info table, so dot info table, will be as a pandas data frame. So that means that I can get all that holdings data directly out as a pandas data frame. I won't go through all the different types of filings that are available, but as you can see, Edgartools is an amazing module for parsing and extracting data in a formatted manner from the SEC Edgar API. That's it. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please like and consider subscribing so that you get notified of my future videos.